I'm Kyrene Superintendent Laura Toenjes. From the teachers making magic in our classrooms to the heroes among our support staff who keep it all running, there is so much about Kyrene that many people never get to see. So I'm shining a spotlight on the people, places, and programs that make Kyrene so exceptional. I will also use the series to show you some of the events and activities happening around our district. I'm really excited about this month's video because we are taking you behind the scenes and behind the camera to shine a spotlight on Kyrene production. I want to show you how we make all of the incredible videos that help inform our community, train our employees, and promote our schools. And the magic starts right here in the Kyrene studio. I'm here with Kyrene videographer Josh Belpate, who is usually on the other side of the camera. And we are in the district studio. Josh, can you show us around?
Sure. Here, let's go look. So, back before I was here in Kyrene, they had this as the studio, in quotes. And when Damien showed me around when I got hired, he's like, this is what we got.
And well, that's lovely.
A giant green screen, yeah. And I kind of keep it up in honor of that. But we do use it for like group photos and stuff like that. When we don't have a group photo, we use this green screen, which is like a single use, one, two people type thing.
So what is the purpose of a green screen?
Oh, let me show you, watch. So on a green screen, it gives you an endless opportunity to put yourself wherever you want. For instance, if I snap my fingers, I can be transported here. Or here. Or even if I clap my hands, I can have as many friends as I want. But if you come over here, this is like the main set that we use. We usually have a single chair, or we can put two chairs. We have tables, and we can dress up these shelves for whatever type of video it is. And then this is another little set here. I have the desk out. Custom made, again, K-Kid down there. And then we have our shelves here, and that is the whole set.
Talk about creating a video from beginning to end.
So videos, even though they might last 2 minutes or 3 minutes, are very complicated. Usually it starts with an idea. Someone will reach out to me. So I always ask who the audience is and what's their end goal. So from there we kind of go, it involves a script writing process. It involves scheduling of when we go out and get our B-roll, which is additional footage that we put on top, and any other elements like filming on the green screen or voiceovers, and then of course editing, which kind of puts it all together, and from there we have a complete video, and then hopefully everyone's happy.
We send a lot of emails, and sometimes that can be information overload. How do videos help us share information and tell our story?
So videos are pretty important nowadays with everything on social media. Even since I started doing video stuff, TikTok, Snapchat, all those things, parents don't have the time to read a lot of the text, right? So if they're scrolling through Facebook or social media or Instagram or whatever, and they see a video that's a minute, 2 minutes long, you know, they're a lot more likely to stop and look at that and get the information that way and retain it more than getting a wall of text in an email. So videos have actually become very important in certain things that we want to communicate to them.
Josh also broadcasts our governing board meetings for the public. And during the pandemic, his live streaming skills grew. What was it like producing virtual events this past year?
Board meetings are one thing here because we have the setup and everything is easy to flip on. But when we had to do everything on Zoom, it was at first a little tricky to figure out how the best way to do it. But once we got it, it really became just as easy, if not easier. But another thing is all the events we usually do in person, such as the retirement ceremony or our years of service ceremony, and even our eighth grade promotion ceremonies that schools would individually do, we actually made live videos that we put together ahead of time and then live streamed them so people could all chat with each other while they watched it. That was also really important too because we were able to still honor, you know, our employees and our students.
Well, thank you, Josh. Huh. Thank you to Josh for stepping in front of the camera to give us insight, individual storytelling, and sharing information through video. As you heard, Kyrene Video Production serves our schools, our governing board, our staff training, our marketing initiatives, and our community. So next time you see a Kyrene video, you will know a little bit more about how it came together through hard work, creativity, and a little bit of magic. I'll see you next month for another Spotlight on Kyrene.